You packed your bags and shut the door. You crossed the sea to fight a war. You didn't know just what would happen.
Good night, and thanks to the millions who have watched and the thousands who have commented on the 13 videos I have produced to honor the fallen 13 and the 18 wounded in Afghanistan. My name is Gregory Bruce, and I am the director of Broken Arrow Productions and a retired U.S. Navy Vietnam combat veteran, having served in the U.S. Coast Guard as well. It has been my honor and consider it my duty to memorialize the 13 brave souls who tragically lost their lives and the 18 who were critically wounded in the Taliban suicide bombing during the Afghanistan withdrawal debacle. Now it is time that I reveal my uncensored opinion about the people who are directly responsible for the 13 senseless deaths and the wounding of 18 other brave heroes. This will be the first Christmas that 13 Gold Star families will no longer have their daughters or sons to celebrate with, and the 18 families of the wounded who have to be with their son or daughter in hospitals or rehab centers recovering from their wounds. It breaks my heart and angers me beyond control at times, knowing full well that the current President of the United States and his band of criminal thugs are nothing less than murderers of these 13 brave heroes who gave the ultimate sacrifice, and the 18 wounded who are still suffering, serving our great country and each other. They died with pride and service to our country, and every one of them loved their job, to quote Marine Corps Sergeant Nicole Lee Angie, who was one of those killed. We all know that Biden never listened to his top military advisors and generals about keeping at least 2,500 troops there, and instead he moved the withdrawal process from the Bagram Air Base, where there was tight security, and a prison housing thousands of ISIS and Al-Qaeda prisoners. Instead, he moved the evacuation to the airport in Kabul, where it was surrounded by the city and tens of thousands of innocent Afghanis, Taliban, ISIS, and Al-Qaeda, with virtually no security except for fencing and a short wall. As a result of this move on August 26th of this year, the Taliban, or ISIS if you prefer, suicide bomber blew himself up, killing 13 and wounding 18, along with hundreds of Afghanis and their children. The bombing would never have happened if Biden hadn't made a deal with the Taliban and evacuated Bagram Air Base, allowing the Taliban to open up the prison, letting ISIS and Al-Qaeda prisoners loose to kill anyone in sight, which indeed did happen and continues to happen. He then pulled our troops out completely, leaving behind hundreds of Americans and thousands of Afghani translators and their families to be slaughtered. Finally, it took a group of veteran special forces operators to defy the State Department, ignore Biden's lack of concern, work their way into Afghanistan and bring home hundreds of Americans and their families, leaving the State Department to actually deny them help by not allowing the aircraft to land in America, and then denying they actually accomplished this. Biden is a murdering son of a bitch and a bastard of a coward, giving in to the squad of so-called radicalized Muslims in Congress. Pelosi and the rest of the Democrat traitorous cowards, including the Obamas and the Clintons, who are destroying our country from the inside. This Build Back Better bullshit has to stop now by remembering to vote next year for those with common sense, putting America first, running for either election or re-election for the House and the Senate. They must remember and honor our sons and daughters who are Marines, sailors, soldiers, and airmen, and not let it be a part of their political agenda. I have uploaded this video to the Rumble platform, headquartered in Canada, as YouTube would most certainly shut me down. Thanks for watching, and hopefully now you might understand what people from all over the world are saying, including myself as a combat veteran of the U.S. Navy, entering the service in 1964 and arriving in Vietnam in 1965 as a young 18-year-old Special Operations sailor. Merry Christmas, and may God bless all of our troops worldwide, so they may someday soon come home to their loved ones. And please, Lord, God bless America.
It's like a storm that cuts a path. It breaks your will. It feels like that. You think you're lost, but you're not lost on your own. You're not alone. I will stand by you. I will help you through when you've done all you can do and you can't cope. I will dry your eyes. I will fight your fight. I will hold you tight, and I won't let go. It hurts my heart to see you cry. Of life, oh, it finds us all. We're too small to stop the rain. Oh, but when it rains, I will stand by you. I will help you through when you've done all you can do. Won't let you go. No, I won't.